Playing video games with others has been shown to have many social benefits, including building trust between strangers or promoting social interactions between the elderly and their caregivers. Yet other games, even those we might expect to be hugely social experiences, such as the massively multiplayer online game World of Warcraft, with its millions of players, can actually result in largely individualistic and egocentric player behavior. Recent attempts to address this question of how we might better design games that emphasize enriching social interaction have seen promising results by adopting a focus on asymmetric cooperative games. That is, games where multiple players cooperate, but each has unique abilities, information, feedback, rewards, or game mechanics, and therefore vastly different play experiences simultaneously. But it remains unclear what combination of elements are responsible for these games' uniquely engaging, interdependent gameplay. In this paper, we dive deeper into this emerging research theme of enriching social play through asymmetry and interdependence, with a combination of two player experience studies that explore the conceptual spectrum of asymmetric play. To explore this space, we developed a custom prototype game called Beam Around Scotty 2, in which pairs of players take on the roles of courageous space captain Joanna T. Kirk and plucky engineer Scotty. Modeled after popular 3D action games like The Legend of Zelda and Dark Souls, Kirk players use a dual joystick gamepad to navigate a hostile alien world while searching for a means of escape. Meanwhile, using a mouse and keyboard interface on a parallel screen, Scotty players are presented with strategic planning challenges similar to games like League of Legends and StarCraft, as they must manage their limited energy reserves and employ 5 special abilities to help Kirk reach the exit. Scotty's abilities include healing Kirk, erecting protective shield barriers, electro-stunning enemies, deploying bombs, and teleporting Kirk short distances. Our first player study compared symmetric and asymmetric play experiences across 4 conditions. In the first condition, pairs of participants played together using different characters in an asymmetric scenario. In the second condition, they swapped characters, but still played asymmetrically. In the third and fourth condition, they played as the same character in 2 symmetric scenarios. In the twin Kirk scenario, both players played with gamepads, but were also able to deploy their own set of special abilities, deploying their own bombs, shocking their own enemies, teleporting themselves, and so on. In the twin Scotty condition, both participants used multi-touch tablets to deploy their abilities while commanding their own AI-controlled NPC character to navigate towards the exit. The order of these 4 conditions was counterbalanced between participant pairs. Following each condition, participants filled out a series of player experience surveys. At the end of each study, players completed demographic and preference surveys and were interviewed about their experience. Our second player study focused on the more subtle characteristics of asymmetric play by examining increasing degrees of interdependence between player actions through more fine-grained mechanical manipulations of gameplay elements. This resulted in 3 experimental conditions we refer to as loose, medium, and tight coupling between player actions. For example, in the loose coupling condition, Scotty could deploy their shock ability by clicking once on the 3D scene to deploy a persistent shock projectile. In the tight coupling condition, Kirk would first have to throw and embed their axe into an enemy before Scotty could shock it. In general, our results indicate that increasing degrees of asymmetry and interdependence enhanced perceptions of connectedness, social engagement, immersion, and intuitive controls.